Hello, Marc from ADM Investor Services International, with some thoughts this week on China and commodity prices. It's primarily to see the amount of influence we're having, above all because the Chinese are now threatening to intervene in a number of markets, which we'll look at, and also to look at it in the context of the Chinese exchange rate. But let's start off with the GSCI commodity price sector indices. I think the most notable development in recent weeks has been the tailing off, above all in industrial metals and in agriculture. And there is certainly a very strong influence from China in that respect. As one can see, energy has been still going sideways, though getting towards the highs. Industrial metals very much sharply lower. Agriculture somewhat lower, in part response to China, in part actually a function of better weather conditions. So let's move to my second chart, which is the Chinese yuan. And that has certainly been on a fairly relentless move higher, making commodity prices, which are generally priced in dollar, a lot cheaper. But as we've had comments recently from China saying that this may not be the best way of heading off commodity price appreciation, it's not necessarily the solution that they're looking at. Perhaps the most sensitive of all the commodity prices is iron ore. It's unsurprising in the sense that China has also been trying to restrict steel production simply for pollution and environmental concerns. These were largely ignored by steel producers. But now we're in a situation where that just cannot be ignored anymore. And with a threat of intervention, so we've seen the iron ore price collapse basically from those highs. We're almost back at the levels we were seeing back in March. The next one is copper, also highly sensitive, but as one can see, as much as there has been a drop off in response to the threat of Chinese interventions, the underlying demand related to renewable energy and above all to electric vehicles remains fairly robust, particularly given an outlook for a deficit in supply terms. So how do things look over in the agriculture sector? Well, perhaps the most sensitive of all the ones is corn, because that's what China imports a lot and has been importing a lot. And with the combination of better weather conditions in key growing areas, above all the United States, and estimates of a good crop this year. So the corn price has come off. In part, it's also a function of what's going on with pork prices in China, which I'll come to after my next chart, which is the Brent crude chart. I think this is an interesting one simply because crude oil remains the sort of benchmark here. And here, the sort of key factor is really whether Iran actually comes online thanks to an agreement to renew the JCPOA. And leaving oil prices meandering in the range that they've been in since March, going nowhere particularly fast. Now, my final chart is basically to highlight how not everything is always to do with China. Sometimes the Chinese prices for things can diverge very sharply with the US one. And that is a chart of the US lean hog future, which has been marching relentlessly higher with cold storage supplies of pork falling very, very sharply year on year in the latest report that we had. Meanwhile, in China, wholesale pork prices have actually been collapsing on a combination of pig farmers holding out for better prices, fattening up their hogs, but basically in the process, ordering more corn, which increases their cost. But it does emphasize that not everything necessarily marches in the same direction as things go in China. And those are the thoughts for this week.